Hey guys, Edwin Crispy here, and today I'm going to be making a pretty simple and quick video. Basically, I'm going to show you guys how to fix the auto eject issue on these cassette to auxiliary adapters. For those of you whose car still has a cassette player, you probably use one of these to play your music. If yours is giving the issue where it automatically ejects or errors out, it's actually a really, really quick fix. I'm going to show you guys how to do that. All you're going to need is, of course, the adapter. And you're going to need the appropriate screwdriver for your adapter. Mine is a Phillips. So make sure you have that. And I like to have a napkin just so I can put the screws there after I've unscrewed them. So first and foremost, what you want to do is you want to go ahead and unscrew every screw in your adapter. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Okay, now that we got everything unscrewed, you just want to pull it apart. Be careful when you do this because some of these adapters have springs inside, or just some like loose pieces. So be careful when you open it. On mine, I just pry it apart like this and take off the top, and we reveal the inside. All of these look very similar inside, whether you have the Monster one or just any other brand. As you can see, mine is Phillips. It doesn't really matter. They all have the same general structure. And once you're inside, there's one piece you need to take out, and that is this piece right here. That is what we're looking to take out. This is what causes it to air out when it basically goes to play. And reason being is because some cassette players have a mechanism called auto reverse. I'm not 100% sure how it works, but all I know is when it goes to the reverse, this thing actually locks for some reason. It locks and it stops it from reversing. So all you need to do is take out this. It's one whole piece. So we'll go ahead and just pop it out like that, and it comes right off. And we just throw that aside, and that will seriously fix your issue. That's all it takes. Now these are spin freely. These really serve no purpose. I have actually tested this for an entire month without this piece and only these gears, and it's worked perfectly. The only thing is it makes kind of an annoying sound when the gears turn, but other than that, it works fine, so you guys shouldn't be afraid of doing it. It'll work completely fine. And if you get annoyed by the sound of the turning gears, just take out all the gears and it'll work just as fine. And that is all it takes. So once you have it out, just put it back together. Make sure that the gears line up correctly, and we will put it back together. And once you have it put together, it's just ready to use. Just pop in your cassette player and it'll work fine. It will no longer air out. Like I said, once again, if you're annoyed of the sound that the turning gears make, feel free to take them out. They serve no purpose at this point. I might even consider doing it if it continues to bug me even more. Let's see how much more patience I can have with it. And that is it, guys. I hope you enjoyed watching this quick fix, and I hope it helps you guys out. Then that is all. I hope you guys comment, like, subscribe. If you have any questions, feel free to DM me or just drop a comment. See you guys.